All right, I'm sure some of y'all knew something was up, but the two-car solution has arrived. Here's my new 2016 R35 GTR. Just want to do a little walk around. We just finished the wash over at Matt's house. Shout out to Matt. Thank you for helping. So yeah, lots to get into here. So first things first, it's a 2016 45th anniversary car. It only came in one color, which is Silica Brass, which is conveniently also the color on the R34 M-Spec and M-Spec NER. That along with Millennium Jade, so those are the two colors that came in it. And one of 27 in the US, I think one of 72 worldwide as well. I think it was under 100. I saw it was reported 100 in some places, but it looks like 72 worldwide came in this color in 2016. The only real difference is from a typical 2016 GTR, obviously the paint color, and a couple of notable plaques here in the interior. There's a plaque in the center console, 45th anniversary, very nice. Other than that, the interior is just a GTR premium spec. You can see I have a premium spec little tear in the bolster, which seems to be quite quite common. One thing I can report is the cup holders do fit Flanagan's cups, which is really important for us in South Florida, so I'm really happy about that. A1, three cup holders too. There's one in the back so I can transfer. Seats are good. Good for a fat boy like me, or fat girl. No discriminating here. But yeah, let's get through. Let's keep going through the car. So up front, the brakes, 390 millimeters in the front, 380 in the rear. I think it's 6-piston in the front. Brembo's, 4-piston in the rear with a two-piece rotor. You can see it has the floating top hat. Since we just washed it, it's all rusted. Just put new Brembo pads on the front. So I got Michelin Pilot Sport 4S's. Don't know the sizes. I think it's a 255 in the front on a 20. And in the rear, where is it? I don't even see it. Oh, 285 in the rear. So pretty nifty. Paint looks amazing in the sun. I mean, just absolutely pops. I got lucky. This car has 20,000 miles. I put 500 miles on it so far, which is cool. Only mod I've done is I took the tints off because fishbowl is life. Also got really lucky with this car. Seller didn't know, or at least didn't tell me, but has full PPF all the way to the A-pillar, which saved me a crap ton of money, obviously. It's really nicely done too. You can kind of see the edges there. I saw the edge on the bumper just looks really, it looks like it was pre-cut actually. You can kind of see there in the corner. So very cool. I think the headlights are covered too. NACA ducts, everything seems to be covered in the front. So
GDR.
Exactly, Aussie. Perfect GDR. Shout out to Motive Video, right? So working around the side, these wheels suck. I'm not even gonna front, I hate them. These are probably the worst wheels that came on any of the GTRs since this car came out, which was obviously a millennium ago. These are just hard to clean, too many spokes, but I kind of get it, so I'm looking for something else. I really do like the exhaust because they're all polished, pretty rad, but impossible to clean, or keep clean, I should say. So you just have to keep scrubbing them like every other day because they get filled with dirt. I think 2012 and above GTRs came with a full carbon diffuser, you can see here. I always kind of marvel at mass-produced carbon parts, you know, because they would have made thousands of these. That's from the factory. So that under tray goes all the way under the gearbox. Let's see if we can kind of see it. Yeah, you can kind of see with the, it looks like the up pipe kind of piercing through it. So exhaust is cool, really quiet, nothing crazy. I think this one is 545 horsepower stock and the car is bone stock. Yeah, just leave that car. We can't push that thing. If the two of us, we're not even gonna get up to like 3 miles an hour. So what's the point? Be able to bump start that. Yeah, I say don't do it. I'm too tired right now. Matt is tired. We just swapped the wheels on Lefty's 997. The work's way better, but we're having a bit of a fiasco in the front on the spacers. It was a pain in the butt. And I was cleaning this at the same damn time. At the same damn time.
Ooh, what's lurking in the shadows there? A car. Will it run? Will it drive? Probably not.
But definitely looks pretty. So someday, FD time. Come on, Matt. So let's do a little interior tour over here. All right. So I'll keep the door open because it's absolutely hot as hell. Check this out. Starter button, press it. That's rad. I really do like that. Just trying to read my USB memory. Don't have it plugged in, but these cars came with two audio options, Bluetooth or USB audio, so iPod, iPad, whatever. And the one thing I will say is the Bluetooth audio option sucks. Don't do it. You can plug in and the sound is just infinitely better. Always, that's gotta be the way to go. Gauge cluster, bunch of switches on the steering wheel, paddles, you see here. Has adaptive, I think it's adaptive cruise control, or maybe not, just regular ass cruise control. Call button, seek, volume, change the source here. Your paddles, speedo goes to 220. I've had it up to 120, so I got a long way to go. But yeah, really comfortable. I will say best part of the car by far, I mean on the interior side, that Bose sound system, it's impressive. It really is good for a stock sound system. So everyone seems to know about the multifunction display. Pretty nifty little piece of kit. You can rotate this button and get a number of different views. I can customize the views. That's the one I've been using here is custom view 4. Trans oil, coolant temp, engine oil pressure, usual stuff. G's, torque split, cornering G. So this is cool for track. And then what do we have? Boost, engine oil pressure, and engine oil temp, which is probably the one I need to have out most of the time. Pretty cool, so you can at least see if there's a boost leak or not. But yeah, really nifty. Really, really cool. So these are what turn the car into a monster. Holding these down, swapping into R mode, stiffens the suspension, changes the shift strategy, the lashing between the gears, downshifts, all of that, and then traction control as well. I think the traction control has a change to the exhaust if there's an internal flapper valve. I know on the newer ones there is, but not sure about this. So that's all really cool. This is a bit annoying, the gear shift. I mean, nothing crazy, it's just a little quirky, just getting into reverse and drive, etc. The backup camera sucks, let's see if I can, just so you can see. Backup camera, crappy. Put it back in the park. Other than that, pretty run-of-the-mill Nissan interior. I like the leather appointments, pretty good, but it's so much better on the 2017 and newer. The interior just changed and made it just way nicer car, but this is fine for me. It's really clean, really, really clean interior. So then you can see the floor mats as well, with GTR emblem. So yeah, that's the interior of the GTR. Decided to have a little impromptu photo shoot. Matt's on the ones and twos again, AKA the camera. Lloyd shook, DJ Lloyd shook. Shaking with it. Silica brass just looks so nice in the sun. Yeah. Ooh, it is hitting this golden hour, bro. Golden hour. So yeah, I'm happy with the car so far. Lots to do to it. Suspension, wheels, trying to figure that out. And then maybe exhaust. That's really it, dude. I don't want... This is a daily. It is the daily. It's the two-car solution. The second car. So, yeah. Well, that's it from Casa de Matt. Thanks for tuning in for the reveal, the big reveal of the R35. And you'll be seeing more of it on the channel soon. So, peace.